era of information have changed everything. There is something going on, and you could tell. And it's not like something, somewhere in the world, that is happening. It's important to understand what data is and how we can use it. Knowing is protecting. If I understand what is going on, I want to participate. How can we make people understand that this data that they collect is much more than they think?
Que el mayor desafío de los datos abiertos está en crear cultura en torno al uso y la funcionalidad de ellos. Open Source, Open Data, tiene mucho que ver con crear sistemas más eficientes y colaborativos entre las personas. Si yo te ayudo a ti y tú me ayudas a mí, vamos entre los dos a crear una mejor solución, más que si yo me siento solo y me encierro y intento buscar una solución que creo que puede ser óptima. Creo que el dato abierto y compartir desarrollos y el open source es, al final, saber escuchar cuáles son las necesidades reales de las personas y crear soluciones reales, tangibles y atingentes a la situación de hoy en día.
I think now responsibility comes more to ourselves. Us, as educators, we need to change mentalities. We need to show the new generations the approach, the strategies. How do you make this work with communities? How do you make this large? How do you make this big? Pomaire is a rural town, around 10,000 inhabitants, around 60 kilometers southwest of Santiago.
Pomaire se caracteriza por tener talleres familiares. Acá no hay industria, no hay nada de eso, solamente talleres familiares. Y que esto es de generación en generación. Nuestro movimiento diario es la semana de producir artesanía y los fines de semana venderlo, sábado y domingo. Hay muchos hornos también, que realmente deben haber unos 200, 300 hornos en el pueblo. Imagínese de sábado a domingo, o sea, de lunes a viernes cocimos, sábado y domingo lo dejamos para el turismo.
We know that particulate material can create not just environmental issues, but also health issues. And inefficient combustion of wood burning creates that these particulates stay in the environment and we breed them.
Yo, como artesano alfarero de Pomaire, conocí a don Camilo hace como 5 años y a la vez ideamos proyectos hacia medio ambiente, y en una de esas ideamos el chancho sensor, que se trabaja solamente de greda. Ese chancho lo fabricamos, hicieron varios diseños hasta que llegamos al diseño final. Se logró el objetivo porque lo colocamos en varias partes del pueblo, que incluso acá en Pomaire se poco, porque siempre conocían el chancho cancía y todo, pero lo miraban que llevaba el sensor y era el captador que teníamos.
They can measure things like the temperature of the ovens, particulate material, the entry and exit of people to Pomaire. No one has ever measured any of these things here, so why don't we do it?
Entonces, para nosotros, y para todos se informó y todos captaron la idea, todos captaron que era un problema de Pomaire, no podían ser ciegos de que había que buscar una solución.
Tal vez lo que habría que ver es una manera de acceder rápido a lo de abajo, porque lo que tenemos acá es la fuente de energía, que es la batería.
Ya, claro. Pero ¿cuánto tiene que estar ya alto? ¿Cuánto?
Más de 40 ya está más o menos. Más de 80,
peligroso.
Crítico. cuando lo ponemos en el horno, cuando Adrián estuvo haciendo las medidas, puso cuatro distintos sensores a una distancia.
We created this philosophy of working out with open source hardware and software. We have our philosophy on of opening up the data, but we also realize that opening up data is not enough. We need to really focus on more education on what to do with data and how we transform this data into information and action. And I think we are just at the beginning of that process. This data can actually build up a way to understand a dynamic of a system. Based on that, they have started a process of changing ovens. They say, well, this oven not just produces less particulate material, but at the same time reduces the use of wood, so it makes more efficient for our economic purposes, so we can change decision. And for us, that makes sense to create sensors and to create data. If we don't have that, then we're just creating interesting gadgets, but that they don't really make sense. For them, it changes life. And for us, and for me, it was very important to that our team and my students also see this, that they can actually make a change that is real.
We are here in Patagonia. This is like the south of south. Here, science is like in a human scale. Scientists are not like those gods that you cannot see or you cannot ask anything. Here people know that we need to take care of this place. This place is a touristic place, so their wages are involving tourism. So if we destroy the landscape, we'll destroy like the economic system of the place. ¿Qué no tiene un celular en el bolsillo ahora? Que levante la mano. Todos lo tienen. Ah, investigando en internet, me metí a Instagram, empecé a cachar que en el hashtag Torres del Paine se subían al principio como 10.000 fotos por mes con el hashtag y actualmente como 50.000 fotos por mes en temporada por hashtag. Entonces dije como, ok, somos todos ya monitores.
La tecnología. El UN is one of my highlight projects. It's an image recognition software that wants to collect data to know how the environment is kind of looking, how the landscape looks.
The system alone includes an app, and the app is to be used here in like protected areas, so we can make mappings of the biodiversity of the places through the pictures that people is already like collaborating with.
The idea is that people that goes inside the park, download an app, press start, and then walk around, take normal pictures. If they want to participate in our project, my app do a geofencing through the areas that we're working on. They will share this information with us. All the pictures pass through a system that make them tags. It's just data in a hot map, like, okay, in this area we can see that there is a macro community of whatever plant. And that's what I see in a point in a map. It's not that I'm gonna see your picture, actually, but your picture have this information.
Well, Loon is an open source platform that recognizes images and turns that into useful information. In our environmental studies, we're doing a baseline, which takes a lot of man hours if you were to keep teams up in those vast areas. Loon enables users to actually contribute to the information. And the baseline is very useful to see how we can develop without impacting delicate ecosystems, how climate change is affecting different species, different habitats. Maybe people or trails going through the wrong place, maybe we're cutting a biological corridor, but we don't know. So Loon's gonna help us know.
I want to gather data and to be useful to everybody. Collecting my data, understanding what is going on, that's humanizing a problem that is huge, but it's in my scale. So that's what open source for me is. It's a tool for empowering people.
Communities like Pomaire can be found anywhere. Around your corner, your neighborhood, your rural community around you. So my suggestion is find your Pomaire, find your Orlandos, your partners.
There are many ways you could help and
like make people understand how important it is to not take care of this place in particular, to take care of places here. Every picture that you take is beautiful. Everywhere that you go, like, oh, this is so amazing. So people fell in love with this place. And here is how you teach them, like, yeah, you love this place. Everything could be like this if we really were aware that what is going on and how to protect and how to take care.
These are not technological projects. These are societal projects. We need to better understand our communities, to better relate ourselves with communities. And suddenly, small changes, like in a very small community, rural community, can actually bring you ideas of a larger change. So let's start small and make it big.